Hey there, I am Parth Doshi, exploring the field of RPA and sharing my learnings with you by making videos. So let me give you an overview of what we'll be doing in this tutorial. So in this tutorial, we'll use a generate input field feature of UiPath Forms. So without any further delay, let's just start with the implementation. Now, to create the form or to use UiPath Form, we need to install a package UiPath.formActivities. For that, you need to click on Manage Packages, go to All Packages, type over your UiPath.form and install it. After you have installed that, you will get an option to create form. So as we can see over here, we'll drag this. Now, we are going to use this particular feature, Generate Input Fields. So now, a basic or a generic way of creating a form is clicking on Open Form Designer. So we have the form designer in front of us and dragging the fields whichever you want. So let's just drag some random fields, say number. So this is a normal way which we can do and create a form, but we will not use this way and we'll create the form just by creating arguments and variables. So let me close this. Now, to use this particular feature, you need to enable it. After that, you need to click on Form Fields Collection. So I've clicked on this and we'll just create a basic form which will have first name, last name, and we can include email ID and a phone number. Or we'll see what all we can include. So here you need to create an argument name. You need to change it to out. I am changing it to out because after creating the form, after we have the fields in our form designer, I am going to display the data which user gives as an input during the runtime outside the form in a message box. Now, after you have created the argument, create the variable with the same name. So it is case sensitive, so you need to take care of that. Name will include email ID. You can change it to out, or let's not include that. We can include hobbies. Let me copy this, create a variable, paste it over here. Hobbies, you can type here interest areas. Copy this, change it to out, keep it as string and paste it over here. So now let's click on OK. So this is just because I'm explaining you this particular feature. I'm creating a very basic form. You can do the changes according to the application. Now, as you can see, we have added the three fields. So what is the error? Okay. Now the error is gone. The variable was not created properly. So after you have done this, now in the form, we should have this particular three fields, name, hobbies, and interest area. So now let us open the form designer and see whether we have that fields on. So as you can see, form fields collection is updated. Do you want to update the form? So this particular message box or this particular message prompts us that we have changed the form field collection. Also, we have selected the generate input fields. Now, because we have this particular message prompting to us, we are sure that we have successfully created the form. So now as you can see here, we have all the three. So I need to just drag this and put it in last. Now I can maximize this. Now if you want to edit this, you can make the N capital. Okay, so you can save it. You can also make this field as required. So the field is always required to be filled in by the user. Settings, you can do this test formatting. This could also be done when we were creating. So we could keep the first letter as capital and that wouldn't be a problem. Validation, keep it as required. Field key remains the same. So make sure you write this field key properly because that will help us to extract the data outside the form. Now we have this. Now you can add themes if you want. So you need to click on preview, themes, and let us keep this particular thing. You can keep any of the themes. Also, you can change the size over here. So we can do it as 400 by 400. We can keep a small type of form. So exit preview and save it. So as we saw, we just created the form fields collection and we selected the generate input fields option and we were able to get all the particular fields which we kept in the form field collection in our form. Now let me save this and drag a message box. So in the message box, I'm just going to display the data which we get through forms. So in message box, here in the text output, we first have name, you need to name, and then this is a small piece line of code you can say we need to write if we want to display it on the next line. Name, then we add hobbies, then again the variable over here plus the environment dot new line. Now after that, one more we have is interest areas colon again over here. Okay, so we don't need over here. Let me click okay. So now what we have done is we have created the form field collection using generate input fields and we are displaying the data in a message box after the user submits the form. Now let's run it and see whether we are able to get the expected output. Okay, so we have, I'm just going to fill random details, par, hobbies, learning about tech, interest areas, RPA, UI path, and then submit. Now we should get a message box with all. So as you can see, we were able to access all the details outside the form. So if you want to perform some string manipulation or you want to save the data into an Excel file or anything like that, you can do that easily because you have the form data in your variables. So now just let's do a quick recap of what we were able to understand in this particular tutorial. So we used the generate input fields, which help us to create the form fields without actually designing them using the form designer. So that was the thing which we learned in this form. Also, I will add some resources of UiPath, like a video from UiPath Academy and UiPath Docs, where you can explore more about the UiPath form activities. Also, please do subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon to stay updated to whatever videos I upload. Thank you.